wait for me.
Enemy fire! Contact soldier 100 meters behind us.
Contact. Yeah, I see you guys.
Reinforcements are approaching your position from Saint-Denis-le-Gast. Out. Rally 3 to all units. Heavy contact being reported up and down the line. Sounds like the real push is on. Give them hell, boys. Out.
Shit. taking us? Where's he going? Oh shit. Hey. Where should we go now?
All units, this is Rally 3. Baseline versus being overrun. Say again, versus Subar. Get your asses back to baseline assets. Over.
Rally 3 to all units. Reinforcements are on the way. Rally 3 out.
A large number of enemy armor has been spotted heading in your direction. Begin it! And good luck! Prowler 3 out!
That's us. We gotta defend this spot. Oh no.
Fuck!
You're okay, buddy.
Shit. Figgy's down. I didn't see where he went down.
Back in the fight, soldier.
Awaiting orders.
Thank you. do it, guys. We'll make it back. Guy. tank. I just don't know what we're gonna do about it. Oh my god.
Gotta get down.
That was like a full squad of guys. Someone got it. It's a Sherman or something.
Tank, 600 meters southwest. Southwest.
Rattler 3 to all units. Looks like we managed to run. To all units. The flow of enemies breaking through from Rossi appears to be contained for the time being. It's all over for these fellas. Reports coming in of routed Germans surrendering. Rest assured, we got plenty of heavy ordnance left for the holdout. It's curtains for them. Outstanding work. I want you to evacuate the wounded, shore up those defenses, and await further orders. Powerhouse 6, out.
Nice GGs.
On July 29th, right before midnight, a German column the size of an infantry company approached and attacked U.S. defenses south of Saint-Denis-le-Gast. With the use of flares, the Germans brought down rocket and machine gun fire to destroy American outposts. Approximately 1 hour later, with heavy fighting still going on to the south, the next two enemy columns, consisting of more than 600 men and supported by roughly 90 armored vehicles and tanks, attacked U.S. positions situated to the north of Saint-Denis-le-Gast, attempting to reunite with their units in the south. The Germans managed to break the American outpost lines and pushed towards the positions of the 67th Armored Regiment, where one Mark V tank rushed through hedgerows, destroying one half-track and dealing heavy damage to defenders. Despite the chaotic situation on the battlefield, U.S. forces were able to stop most of the attackers in man-to-man battle. Nevertheless, a small German unit of 11 vehicles and almost 100 troops managed to slip through the lines, rush through Saint-Denis-le-Gast, and then continue westward. At 02:15 hours, this column reached the bivouac area of the 78th Armored Field Artillery Battalion, just 1 mile east of Longren. American officers taunted the first truck of the column in German, and when they received the answer, Was ist, U.S. machine guns and howitzers opened fire. At an average range of 50 to 175 yards, the enemy had no chance. This engagement led to 205 captured and 90 killed German soldiers. During the night from the 29th to the 30th of July, the 2nd Armored Division succeeded in preventing German units trapped in the pocket around Raincy from crossing their lines at multiple points, notably in Saint-Denis-le-Gast and Cambrai, where Germans took tremendous losses. In spite of that, one Mark IV tank battalion, with sizable contingents of infantry, managed to flee the region, escaping towards German positions in the south. Despite this minor success, in the morning of July 30th, remaining Germans in Raincy were left with no hope, and that day, the area was cleared and the town liberated. During that horrific night of July 29th, more than 1,500 Germans lost their lives and 4,000 were taken as prisoners. American forces suffered 100 dead and 300 wounded soldiers.